Oh, here it comes. All right, I don't got time to wait. And what the fuck? How's it going, everybody? Dragast here, and welcome back to another episode of Planet Coaster. So it's been a little while since we played this one. I know, I heard you guys in the comments a million times. Where the fuck is Planet Coaster? Trust me, I have heard you. We are back into it, but I will say there's going to be a lot of changes now. Last time we played, the alpha was actually out. Now the beta has been released, and there's a lot of new changes to this. So I'm actually going to restart my park. Now I know what you're saying, oh Daddy Dre, why would you do that? You work so hard on your other park, and to be honest, I'm kind of over the other park. We had a lot of projects going on, and it was all kind of mishmashed together. I mean, we had an apartment building with a volcano behind it with a fucking floating island on top of the volcano. And it was just too much for me, you know? I just want a simple park that makes sense. Not only that, the game has been updated like I stated, and the parks are supposed to be like two or three times the size now in terms of landmass, so we have a lot more room to work with, which is a really good thing. So now I can have kind of a city place, a volcano, and a pirate place, and it won't all be jam-packed together and kind of confusing. Not only that, a lot has been updated into the game. I saw a trailer for the beta, and I saw a fucking coaster crash into a million people. And you know we are gonna try that probably today. That's gonna be like my first goal. There's also supposed to be like water park rides and everything and more roller coasters, of course. So this game is much bigger than the last time we played. Now we can play career. I'm kind of more of a sandbox guy though. I do like the idea of managing a park, and I think we will do that later on. But for right now, I want to see what this game has to offer, and sandbox is really the perfect mode for that. So we're gonna open up a new sandbox here. Now, which do we want? We can either have tropical, desert, grassland, alpine, deciduous, or my parks. Well, I'm not gonna do my parks because, well, not only, I didn't even get to the point where why I'm not doing my park. First of all, yes, it's all crazy and everything, but I actually loaded up the park, and for whatever reason, no customers will come into it. And I talked to my Planet Coaster buddies, and I guess that's a common issue when you're reverting an alpha save to a beta save. It makes lots of issues. So instead of dealing with those issues, we're just gonna start fresh. I think I'm excited for it. You know, the other park had a lot going on, and I just want a more relaxed gameplay. So I'm thinking, I think a lot of people are gonna do tropical, so I'm not gonna do that. I think I'm gonna do alpine. Just because alpine wilderness is beautiful. Deciduous as well, that would be kind of cool, but I'm sticking with alpine. I feel good about it. Now, name my park. I'm not going to change the park name because I did vote for it with you guys, and I'm going to keep it at Parky McPark Base because you guys are, let's just say you guys are interesting. I don't want to be rude or anything. So we're going to start new with Parky McPark Face, and I don't know what we're going to do today. We're just going to look at what's new in the game and start building a park. It's as simple as that. And here we are. Oh, wow, that's fucking beautiful. Okay, so yes, as you can see, compared to the other size, this is a much bigger park. Look at how big this place is. Now, is there any entrances this time? Okay, so we do have to kind of build our own entrance because here is where all the customers are going to come in through the mountains again. I don't know what is up with Planet Coaster and customers coming through the fucking mountains. I've never went to a park where you go through a fucking mountain. Okay, so we could focus on making a very pretty entrance and having it look amazing, and I will do that later on, but for right now, I'm all about the rides, man, so we're gonna do that. Now, I have to make a big decision. What kind of road do I want in my park? I kind of like this cobblestone road that it started with, to be honest, so I think we're gonna do that for right now. Now, let's expand the length of this, because I like the idea of straight paths. I don't know, I'm weird. My last park had basically three paths splitting off from each other, and I think I'm gonna do more or less that again. So first of all, let's just build a nice big straight line all the way down. That should be more than enough space. All right, park's open. Come and enjoy it, ladies and gentlemen. There's a lot going on here. You leaving? Okay, well, screw you too. All right, but let's look in here really quickly just to see what's going on. We got different types of coasters. There's blueprinted coasters. So is this a whole coaster that's blueprinted? I'm assuming yes, it is. So you can, if you want lazy mode, you can actually go to the blueprints and print a whole coaster. That's pretty amazing, to be honest, because I like the idea of doing quick parks as well. But we can also obviously go to custom, and then you can choose the coaster that you want. Now, what new ones do we got in here? I'm seeing a dragon. What is this thing? This is a Wendigo. Okay, a train, a canyon runner. Oh, please tell me that's a wooden track. Chain lift, cannot invert for all ages. I'm hoping it's wooden, though. It doesn't look like it is, though. All right, so that's all the new coasters. We got track rides as well. We got the boom boat, which I'm really excited about. This is a water-based ride. Oh, this is the blueprint for it. There should be actually a couple of them in the track rides here. I keep forgetting we have blueprints now. So we got the log flume, which is basically a log ride. We also got a river rapids thing. Oh, these things are so fun. I think I'm going to build this first, to be honest. I do like any sort of water-based rides. We also got a monorail if we do want to, you know, do some transportation around and some other things as well. Now, in terms of rides, anything really new in here? A hyperspin, that's definitely new. So yeah, there's a lot of new stuff. I'm assuming there's a lot of new shops and facilities as well. Once again, we can use blueprints or we can make our own. I think when it comes to shops, I might do a lot of blueprints. In terms of new stuff we can use, yeah, there's so much more in here. I know you guys really don't see the difference, but yeah, there's a lot going on in Planet Coaster now, and I'm really excited to get started here. All right, so for today, I don't think we're going to do much park planning. We're just going to have some fun with some rides, so I do want to bring some customers in here. So let's start off with some new rides here. So we got, this thing looks new. Cycola. All right, let's try this out. It looks like it just spins around, possibly. So I kind of want these a little bit away from the entrance to my park because I'll probably do a lot of concession stands there and whatnot. So we're going to put this right here. And it's supposed to be easier to do the entrances and whatnot now. At least I've been told that. So we're going to place the entrance over here. Place exit. I guess we can just connect it right to that and connect entrance path. So I don't think you need to make ticket booths anymore, which is kind of big because they were really annoying to deal with before. So I wanted to use obviously the rock here or at least something close to it. That looks pretty damn close. So we're just going to do, again, I don't want to go too small with my queue lines. We had that issue last time. So we're just going to wrap this thing around and make this pretty damn big. All right, there we go. We're just going to wrap all the way around this thing. I feel like this is the best way to do a queue line because it doesn't obstruct a lot of the open grass area. So let's just do this all the way to the exit path. And basically, you know what? We could probably just connect them together. You know what? That might make traffic issues. So let's just do this instead. So now we don't have to actually build a ticket booth. It's just it's automatic. And the ride status is closed, so let's first of all test this thing out. So I guess it's going to test it automatically here. We can speed this up to see what's going on with this one. So I guess, yes, it just spins around and then flips people upside down. Kind of a cool ride, very simple. I like the brain in the middle. That's really cool. I didn't even notice it was kind of like a sci-fi stylized ride. So there must be some new sci-fi stuff in the game, which is fun because, well, sci-fi is awesome. Everybody knows that. Okay, test rating, excitement is 3.94, fear is 3.42, and nausea is 4.57. I think that's probably rather bad. It doesn't feel like it's going that fast, though. I don't see how anybody could get sick on this. I mean, I understand you're spinning, you're rotating up and down, but it takes a lot for me to get sick personally, so it's just confusing to me that this would make anybody sick, to be honest. Okay, so can we just simply stop the test? Ride status is closed, so can we open it up? There we go, we even get fireworks now, look at that! Alright, do we got anybody in my park? Okay, some people are finally coming in. So basically what I want to do right now is gain population to my park. Now how am I going to do that? Is by doing as many rides as possible. So we got this first one going on. Well, they're going to that, let's do another one right beside this. So what else haven't we seen before? The Looper, that seems new, and that is very fucking big. Another sci-fi ride. So maybe this should be our sci-fi area, you know, we'll kind of plan it out. Now, it's been a while since I played. I actually forget how to rotate the rides. Okay, so there we go. I figured it out, but I think it's actually different with this as well, so that's pretty cool. I think this is good. We'll place that right there. Place an entrance. We'll loop this around again, so we'll just put this over here, and we'll place the exit right in front of it again, because that kind of works well. Let's put these right beside each other so it looks nice. All right, we can connect that right there. So once again, we're going to test up this one, see what this does. I'm spending a lot less time on the rides this time. In our last series, we kind of spent a lot more time on the rides. I want to do as much as possible today. Oh, this looks like such a cool ride. I'm loving these sci-fi rides. Oh, this would make me sick because you can't really judge which way your body's going to go. You know what? Let's go in the first person and see how this really feels. So, ride camera, there we go. We're going first person. Yep, that would be called the vomit comet to me. Because then you don't know where your mind's going, you don't know which direction you're going. This is where I would get nauseous. And I'm curious to see the nauseous rating on this. Yes, we got a 6.03 this time, but an excitement rating of 6.98. So this one's way more exciting than this little ride over here. Okay, everything seems fine though, so we're going to stop test, open this one up as well. Now I know you can actually deal more with park management now. You can see guest summaries now. Oh, this is what I love. I love stats about anything. So park entry is free. That's kind of an issue. So let's go ticket prices. Standard entrance. I guess I don't really need money. I have unlimited money anyway, so why not make it free? I want to have the most populous park ever. Now, obviously, when we get into the career mode, we'll have to be more strategic with our money and our spending. Right now, we basically have limitless money so we can have fun. All right, let's add some shops and facilities here. And again, I'm going to go to the blueprints for this, but just because I just want to build as much as I can today to kind of look at what's new in this game. So we got, this is kind of cool looking, a toilet shack, but I kind of want to stick with the sci-fi. Do we got anything sci-fi in here? Okay, there we go. So we got some sci-fi stuff. We got the sci-fi chief beef, if it ever loads. So let's rotate this. And you know what? Actually, I think we're going to make, you know what? Before I do that, I kind of want to make like a food station. So let's build a path off of this path and actually do a food station away from the actual amusement park rides. So we're just going to kind of build it this way over here. All right, now that we're out of the way a little bit, I feel a little better about this. So we want sci-fi inspired creations here. So let's do, oop, I didn't mean to do that. Nope, let's cancel that. Put it back down again and rotate it a little bit. So let's do, I kind of like these things sideways. So we're gonna make a little bit of a queue line for this thing because usually these things get really populated. So I want to make as big of a line as possible. There we go. Chief Beef is right there. Let's go to the drink stand and do, is there a sci-fi one? There's no sci-fi drink shack? That's kind of weird. Okay, well, we're going to have to do a planet coaster drink shack. This is just weird. All right, which way? Is that the right way? What the fuck is going on with this one? Okay, no, there's the entrance right there. All right, so we can do that like that. And this just looks awful. I know this will not be our finalized park. Let me just say that. We're just having fun today. All right, so we got food and drink. Let's do a gift shop on the other side. Planet coaster hats. Holy shit, this one's big. Okay. Maybe we should spread this out a little bit. I didn't think these things would be so big, but I kind of like the idea of just like a chaotic park. So we're gonna put this over here for some hats. Of course, we need some restrooms. Restrooms are very important. Toilet shack, fairy tale village toilets, or Bonzo the clown. Of course, with all the fear of clowns lately, yes, everybody's gonna want to use that fucking bathroom. It's not even a happy, pretty clown. This guy's got some beefed up teeth. I mean, he's got, is this supposed to be hair? This is horrifying. All right, of course we need first aid as well. This is just getting weird. There's so many different things. There's a lot of pirate themed places though. So maybe I should have did that. All right, first aid right here, guys. We're just gonna put this right over here. Gotta be safe, guys. And of course we need some ATMs. You know what? Pirate-themed stuff seems to be popular, so we're gonna put some pirate-themed ATMs right beside the pirate-themed first aid area. So there we go. We got some ATMs so they can spend their money. Information booth. Every place needs an information booth. Once again, pirate-themed, so we're gonna stick this one over here. It's shooting at people. That's just fucking grand. Alright, so we got a lot of ticket booths and whatnot. Now, I know we're going to need also some garbage cans, so let's go to scenery here. Is there blueprints? Oh, there is blueprints in this. Oh, this is so cool. So you can do a lot of, you know, theme-based blueprints and scenery. That's what I was hoping for. People to design cool things with the scenery items. And it looks like there's quite a bit in here. Is that a treehouse that I saw down here? That looks like, oh my god, it is a treehouse. That is so cool. We know it. We're just going to put this here because why the hell not? This is just a clusterfuck of a park. We got a clown. We got pirates on the other side. We got sci-fi stuff over here. I mean, it's just confusing as shit. And I love it. Okay, but actually in custom, we should be able to see path extras. There should hopefully be, yes, a barrel bin, a palace bin.
I just want an ordinary bin. Okay, so park bins. We're going to want these things around or this park is going to get messy really quickly. We should probably also hire some entertainers and whatnot, which we will do very soon here. Okay, that's a few too many garbage cans, to be honest. But you know what? At least we won't have garbage on the ground. Now, let's definitely put some by the food stands over here because I got to assume they'll use a lot. So we'll put one right there and one right over here. There we go. And finally, actually, we already got some over here, but let's just put one by the health place just in case. All right, and every good park needs some benches, some palace thrones, some barrel benches. Oh, this is... I'm just getting some good ideas on what to build later on. Of course we want throne benches randomly around. That just totally makes sense. All right, let's see how our rides are doing. They are quite queued up. Let's see how people are feeling about them. Let's go to park management here. And see a good overview of this. Park entry is free. I wish there were more rides, okay? We're gonna get on that. I'm not queuing that long to go on Psychola. The queue line looks fast for Psychola. What? Population, make your mind, is it fast or slow? What the fuck? The litter is disgusting. Okay, let's hire a janitor here. Where do we do that? Okay, staff. Definitely do want a janitor. We're gonna drop that guy. Oh, this is cool. I don't remember it working this way, but we do have some shit around, so we're definitely gonna want to get a few of these janitors, because they are going to be very busy. Now that we got that done, we can also do a mechanic, just in case some rides break down. I guess rides do break down now, which is really cool. That's something that they didn't implement into the alpha. And look at all these new entertainers. These guys over here, a lot of these guys are new. Foxy, of course, we're gonna get a fox. We're gonna get every entertainer here, guys. We gotta keep the kids happy. All right, we're gonna have entertainers out the ass. It's great when you have limitless money. You can just buy everything. So there we go. I think that was... Is there any more? Oh, there is quite a few more. Okay. There's way more than I remember last time. We just had, like, the pirate and the chief beef guy. Now there's, like, princesses. This is great. This is turning into a really good theme park sim. All right, of course we need Chief Beef, and of course we need the T-Rex, and I think that is everyone. So there we go. We got a bunch of entertainers. We got a little bit of a population in the park now. How big are we right now? We're 340 guests right now. All right, so I added some more path. Let's go back to the rides here. You know what? Maybe we should just put down the Blueprint Boom Boat ride. Just to see what it's all about, because I do want to do a lot of the water-based rides today, but I don't have time to obviously build them all. I kind of like the idea of this going, like, over the whole place here. So what if we rotate this like that, and then we could have this literally over our park. Oh, those things are going to look like such an eyesore, though. So no, I don't think that's a good idea. To be safe, let's just put this like this and keep all that junk over on the side there. And I think we're going to kind of do the queue line over the log ride. I like the idea of the waiters being able to see the log ride in action. I don't know. Obviously, it's not going to change anything. They're not going to be any happier by doing this. But I do like the look of it. So let's just put this behind here and then all the way around. All right, so everything is built. We got the queue line, we got the exit line, and of course we got the ride, which we did not build. That was pre-built, but that should be good enough for right now. So let's test this thing out and let's go on it and ride it with the test dummies. All right, so here we are. Oh, it even looks like a log ride. Like, this is how I remember the log ride. Now, this thing should be like a black piece of fabric that you get connected to. A bird just flew through the fucking coaster trails, but yes, here we go. All right, and here is the happy individuals going up the log ride. I love how all the logs are going at the same time, too. So this is going to be a very profitable ride as well, because a lot of people can go on it at the same time. So here we are in the first part of the water. I just want to see what happens when we do the fall, because is there going to be a splash in the game? Because splashing is half the fun of the log rides. A lot of the time, you're just slowly moving around like this, and then you're just waiting for the big-ass drops. All right, here we go to the first very small drop. There's only two drops on this log ride, but I think the second one's going to be a really good one. So this first one, it's just a very small drop, so I don't know if we're going to do any splashes or anything, but I'm excited to see it. So here we go, the first drop. We haven't dropped yet, and a little bit of a splash. There we go, that's all I wanted. All right, and here we are at the top. This is the fun part. I wish this ride was a little bit bigger, but for a blueprint... I mean, yeah, I didn't really expect too much. And this is kind of like a realistic log ride. This is what you would expect. Basically, two drops and a lot of just kind of floating around, as you can see. But this is the one where we're going to make a big splash, hopefully. So I'm excited for it. All right, here we go. My childhood is coming back to me. Whee! Yes. Oh my god, I love this. And that's the splash you want to see. Oh my god, let's watch the person behind me. They're going down now, and watch the size of this. Yes. That looks amazing. I mean, the graphics in this game, I'm so impressed, because the magical part of a log ride is getting wet. Let's be honest here, guys, and that's what it's all about now. Hopefully, nobody gets hit by that. There we go, back to the front. Everything's safe, we're good to go, so let's make this thing live and let the public enjoy it. All right, so our park's getting a little bit better now. As you can see, it's getting a little bit more populated. We got freaking entertainers everywhere. Still looking for a few more people before I do what I want to do today, because I'm kind of excited about that. Our queue lines, though, are really working well. They are getting quite packed, as you can see. So let's see what the public is thinking now that we added that log ride. So 44% wish there were more rides. That's better than before. And people are complaining about the Cycola waiting time. So that's not too bad. We're going to add a couple more rides here. Let's just speed run a couple of them, shall we? So what else haven't we done here? We haven't done the Hyperspin, I don't think. No. So we're going to do that one really quickly as well. The cube. What is the cube? Oh, I think we've seen this one, haven't we? So we're going to add this as well. I mean, we're just going crazy with the rides here, guys. I'm just trying to get as much population in my park as possible. So place entrance once again and do it once again. Ooh, we also got marketing campaigns now to advertise our park. So let's start one of those. Again, we have limitless money, so we may as well go crazy here. What's the most expensive? I'm assuming a TV commercial, late night talk show. TV commercial, family hour, comedy show. So I think we're gonna do comedy show. I feel, no, actually, no, let's close that. Actually, can we have multiples going? Because I kind of want to do the family hour. So yes, let's do that. Let's start a new we can do as many as possible? All right, we're gonna advertise the fuck out of this place. Actually, never mind, we can only do two, but that's totally fine. What else can we do here? Guest, so this is just explaining the guests' feelings, attractions, and shops. Everything's open. Everything's okay. Let's see how they're feeling now. I wish there were more rides. We just added two more, and you guys are still complaining. That's okay, though. Hopefully, we'll add a couple more here. But yes, we got everything set up. I didn't even test these two, but yeah, you get the idea. They're rides, guys. Oh my god, look at this guy. That is such a cool entertainer. That seems a little dangerous, though, to be walking around like that with kids around. Jesus. All right, we're gonna add some green leaves over here, lots of green leaves, and let's put some stuff inside this to make it look a little bit better. Some ironwood, how about that? We're gonna drop that down a little bit just to add some color to this, make it look a little bit more nice. Aw, that's looking not too bad. Again, I'm kind of rushing right now. I mean, I'm sure you guys acknowledge that. But I just wanted to add a bit of nature to the park, and that's looking pretty good. All right, the Screaminator's done as well. Going crazy. I didn't expect this to happen when I started this episode, for me to just go crazy and build a whole park, but it's actually kind of fun. It's really easy to build in this game now, and that's why I like it so much. We're having some population issues here, which is a good thing. That's what I wanted. That was my goal. Let me see how people feel. We got a notification here, so let's make sure everything's okay. End of monthly summary, monthly profit, -3,000. Eh, not too bad. All right, but let's see how people are thinking now. I'm hoping, yes, they're happy with the amount of rides, finally. That took a while. Okay, so now we're going to build a coaster, guys, and I'm going to try and derail that coaster. Because I saw something in the trailer for this game that looks really freaking fun. So my plan is to derail a coaster right around here and try and crash through everybody in this main line. That's the whole goal of this park right now. That was my goal this whole time, because I just want to see some destruction, damn it. So let's go to coasters and do this thing. So we want a really fast one. We don't even need one that does loops or anything. I just want to make sure it's fast, thin, and can get through this whole lane here. All right, this Anubis is a hyper coaster. That's good enough for me. I'm happy with the Anubis, so let's do this really quickly. We're just going to build this thing here, and bad things are going to happen with it, guys. All right, so there we go. We got a bit of a drop, so that should hopefully get us enough speed to go way down here. And then we're obviously going to build a very big hill here. So let's start going up again. We're going to convert to chain lift right away and go straight up. Now, we're going to go crazy with this, guys, and go really fucking high. All right, that should be hopefully enough. I don't think we need much more speed than that. The whole point of this is to make it to the end of that, and I'm assuming when we're going that fucking high, we should be totally fine. Oh my god. All right, this is going to be so fun. I'm so excited, guys. All right, ladies and gentlemen, here it is in all of its glory. As you can see, it is fucking beautiful. Now, I had to put a little bit of a bank here. It wouldn't let me place this final one, so we'll see how this does. I can always change it a little bit if it actually, like, ramps over everyone. I hope it doesn't, but this thing is going to be going, obviously, pretty freaking fast, so you never know. All right, so let's test out this. Obviously, it's not going to work, but that's kind of the point of this. So here we go. Got some test dummies. Oh, there they are. Okay, well, good luck, guys. I'll see you in literally seconds here, because I'm excited. All right, may as well speed up time. I mean, the whole point of this, hopefully it can make it all the way over to there. Yes, no problem at all. And now it's the big climb up to the top. I wonder if we should go on that camera. You know what? That'd probably be a better view. So let's do this. We're going to do a third-person camera view on this thing. Oh, this is going to be so good, guys. All right, ladies and gentlemen, here we go. Our first test, our first actual derailment in Planet Coaster. I've been waiting forever for this. I'm so excited. Oh. God, it went so fucking high. Did it hit anything? All right, let me actually get off this and go see if there's any damage over here. Well, what the hell happened? I think it actually... Okay, well, there's... this dude out here, so I'm assuming he got hit. A few people did must have got hit, because there's people all over the place out here. And of course, we missed it, so I guess going on that camera was a bad idea. I think we got another test coaster going right now, though. So let's check that out really quickly. Looks like it... Is that the main drop? I think it is the main drop. No, it's actually the small one right over here, isn't it? Yep, okay. Alright, well, instead of waiting for that one, we kind of need to fix this, because it's going a little bit too far, so... I don't want to do a little ramp at the end. That is my main issue right now. So let's edit this track, and let's get rid of this. Okay, so the problem is I go into the ground here. So what if I just change this a little bit? Now, what if we build like that? Now, still, that's a little too high. And if I go down, it turns red. That's my problem right now. So what if I shorten the amount of track here, and hopefully it will let me after... Yes, there we go. Okay, so obviously this is... probably my best bet. I want to ram it into the ground and then go through everybody. So let's try this again. This should be a lot better this time. So we're going to build that, close this, and test drive this. Oh yeah, that is the ultimate goal, to hit everybody. All right, good morning everybody. It is test day numero two. This one should hopefully go better. All right, we got to close this. A lot of shit is open right now. And test drive once again. All right, I'm so excited. We're not going to watch from that this time because it kind of resets it once it crashes. So we're just going to go, you know what? I'm going to go kind of in the middle here. I want to get a good view of everything. So we're going to go, I think, right here. This should be good. All right, I think it just made its way to the top. So let's slow down and... it's so hard to patiently wait for this because I've been waiting for this since, like, Roller Coaster Tycoon 2. Oh, here it comes. All right, I don't got time to wait. And... what the fuck? Hold on. Let's pause time and just appreciate this. How many people do you think this is? What? They're everywhere. Where the fuck is the train? That's what I want to know. Okay, so we got... no, that's not even a train track. Where the fuck is the coaster itself? Oh my god, look at the destruction here, guys. All right, there's one coaster right there. It actually stopped. I just love how they all shot straight up into the air. I mean, there's families here. There's kids everywhere. I think that will go down in roller coaster history as the most horrifying crash ever. All right, let's see what happens when these guys land, because I'm God damn it. They're bouncing? Are you fucking kidding me? Some of these guys are seriously bouncing. Look at this guy. All right. Is everybody okay? Everybody's good? I mean, I don't believe that. After that crash, I do not believe that. But they're cheering. They're actually happy. Do you want another one? Because I'll do another one. That was fucking fun. Now, the problem is, are these guys going to be able to get back to the path? Is everybody just going to start walking after they're cheering? Or what happens to these people? I mean, I hit children and they're all happy. This would not happen in the real world. There would be lots of lawsuits right about now. Okay, well, let's wait a second for this to pack up again, and I guess we're just gonna try it again, because that was fucking fun. Oh, and here they all are. Oh my god, so they all spawned to the entrance, and now we just got a big pile up here. Okay, so actually, it's already testing. I forgot. It's automated, so we're just gonna do another one once this is up there. All right, everybody, get back to the park quick because we're going on another ride here. I'm just going to wait at the end here. This is going to be a good view. All right, here it comes. It's at the top, and it just started falling. It should be any time now. Let's move up a little bit here because I don't know how far this thing's going to be able to get. It depends on how many things it hits. There's some people. There's some more people. And unfortunately, it's hitting a lot of the stuff around here, so it's not perfect. You know what? What if we make this go a little further? Let's try that. So I want to make this as straight as possible, so I'm trying to align the track to the sides. That's looking really friggin' good, so if we do a couple of these, it should stay... Okay, it's going a bit to the right, as you can see, so we just straighten it out a little bit more, and that should be good. So let's drop it down now, and that's where all the people are, so that's where I want to go. So, once again, oh, fuck this red, man. I can hardly drop this thing. All right, is that at least going downwards a little bit? Yes, it is. Okay. So we're going to build that and then close this, and this should be a hell of a lot better. It's a hell of a lot more straight, and it's going into where the majority of the population is right here. All right, here it is at the top, so let's slow down time. I'm just going to go straight down to where most of the people are. Hopefully I can fix this camera in time. There we go. So this is where I want to... I'm curious if the entertainers get hit by it too. Oh, shit! Holy fuck! I didn't have time! My god, there they all are. Oh my god, it's literally raining people. Okay, well, sorry for my camera work there, but sometimes it's just hard to prepare. So I'm safe to assume that I think almost everybody got hit that time. That was majestic. And look at them. They're all just... There's a guy fucking floating here. Oh, that's a woman. Sorry, I don't know what she's doing. She seems to be pretty happy, though. And look at all the people at the entrance. They're literally cheering. How did you guys make it inside the cave? That's impressive. All right, and everybody is back at the front once again, ready to be shot again. Now, where is the next train? I think it's already... Oh, it just made it to the bottom of it. So I want to get a better view this time. I'm going to go, and I'm not going to move it from right here. All right, it is a little dark, but you know what? That never hurt anybody. It might actually change to the next day by the time it makes it to the top. There we go. We have reached the top. And we are going to slow this down right now because it is a drop, and it's going to be a nighttime launch this time. Oh, actually, it just turned daytime. Perfect timing. Here it comes. Oh, fucking yes. Let's take a second here. Look at the destruction. It's looking like the entertainers actually don't get hit because they're totally fine. But I just love how it shoots them literally up, straight up into the air. All right, let's watch the rest of this. There we go. It is freaking beautiful. There's something about hitting this many humans that is so fucking rewarding. And there they all come. It actually just got hit once again. These guys are bouncing around. But yes, everybody is back to the entrance. Look at how glitchy it is. I just love that this game is so optimized. I can do this without even lagging. All right, guys. Well, that was another episode of Planet Coaster. I hope you enjoyed this interesting one, checking out the ragdoll physics of crashing, more or less. Next time, we'll actually get into actually building a park, because I know you guys want to see a lot of that. For right now, I just wanted to show you what was released into the game since we last played and just have some fun with actually derailing roller coasters now. So yeah, next time we'll probably be doing a lot of this water-based stuff and starting to build an actual park. I'm thinking of going back to the pirate theme, but let me know in the comments below what you guys would like to see for a themed-based park. As always, guys, I just want to say thank you for watching and liking, and I will see you in the next one.